All right, this broadcast is about the so-called tolerant left. We get a lot of this, you know, on the conservative side of the spectrum. Oh, you need to be more tolerant. You know, you need to be tolerant of trans racism or transracial, like Rachel Dolezal. You know, she's claiming she's black. We have to accept that, even though she wasn't born black. We have to accept she is black. And you have to accept, you know, transgender. You know, this man was born as a man, but now he's a woman. You know, we got to be tolerant, tolerance, tolerance. They always, you know, force this tolerance thing down. If you're not tolerant, then you're a bigot, blah, blah, blah. And then now we're seeing the left out in force. This isn't just a small group of people. This is a fairly large group of people. And we saw it during the Trump rallies. You know, and I wasn't a Trump supporter. I supported Rand Paul, you know, Vermin Supreme, because the choices started getting slim. But, you know, I didn't support Trump, but I am conservative. I teach conservative values. I support conservative values, and I broadcast about conservative values, but I wasn't a Trump supporter. But regardless, I was shocked and amazed, and I think this is probably why Trump won, in part, was that the left came out with such violence. You know, you didn't see Trump supporters going to a Hillary rally. You didn't see Trump supporters going to a Bernie rally. But you saw Bernie supporters mostly, and some Hillary supporters, going to Trump rallies and stirring up shit, and then, you know, sometimes getting their butts kicked over it. Well, same thing happened to me, and I'm going to talk about this in regards to what Sean Hannity broadcast yesterday about this in regards to what's going on with him. But I was attacked. I mean, I've been attacked, you know, ever since I became a conservative, ever since I denounced my family's liberal leanings, which I was raised with. But, you know, for many years, maybe 15, 16 years, I've been leaning more conservative and more conservative as time goes on. You know, I mean, I even supported Ralph Nader for a good long time because I liked his National Initiative for Democracy. Not necessarily that I supported his points of view, but I supported a national referendum policy where, you know, the people get to vote on, it's like a fourth tier of government where the people get to vote on other bills and referendums that get passed. And so I supported Ralph Nader, even though he's left. But more and more, as time goes on, I start leaning conservative as the left gets more and more intolerant and more insane. And so similar to like what's happened with Laura Southern, where she's been attacked at these rallies, she goes and films and, you know, they've hit her with bear mace. They've thrown urine on her, thrown M80s at her, you know, which is basically a quarter stick of dynamite. So they've thrown bombs at her. Cute little 100-pound girl, not anything to be intimidated by. They, you know, burned down Berkeley when Milo Yiannopoulos went to speak, burnt down University of Berkeley. Parts of it, anyway, caused over $100,000 worth of damage just because they feared his speech. I mean, he's a gay guy. He says he, you know, gives oral pleasure to black men. He's not a racist. He's not a cis male, you know, he's a gay dude that, you know, has black boyfriends or whatever. I mean, but they don't like his speech, so they're going to burn down Berkeley because of it. You know, just so much of it has happened, you know, in recent days, the last couple of years, that people are getting sick of it. And I think that is in part why Trump won, is that people were just like, you know what, we got to put an end to this crap. And so Trump won, and of course the country's divided, even more so now than when Obama was playing the race card every day. Now it's like crazy, and you know, they're weaponizing themselves and they're attacking people. This guy, Eric Clanton, allegedly, somebody anyway, with a bike lock, hit another protester over the head and cracked his skull. You can see all the blood running down his face and, you know, his eyes swelling up, and I mean, it was attempted murder at this Battle for Berkeley on April 15th. But in my history recently, and I've reported on this, and then I'll get to Sean Hannity after this, but so, you know, for many years I've been accused of this and accused of that. I believe it's absolutely false accusations, and I believe I can absolutely prove it. And so when I started proving it, you know, like the kid, one of these, you know, slanderers were like, oh, he supports George Bush, oh, he's a racist, oh, he supports you know, this and that, and just, you know, things that aren't true. And I'm like, well, fortunately I've been blogging, you know, since before the internet. I mean, I used to get on bulletin board systems in the early 90s, and then when the internet came out, I've had websites and blogs. And I'm like, you know, if you want me to prove it, just go to archive.org. you can see that what you're saying isn't true. You know, I've put my beliefs out there. I'm very public about what I believe. And so then he starts threatening me and saying, oh, well, I'm going to fight you. I'm going to kick your ass. So I'm like, all right, well, I'm here. I moved all the way from Maine to where he lives to help his mother out, you know, my wife's mother. And, you know, we built her a business, and I got a little fiveplex there, and I paid cash. I paid cash for my fiveplex. I paid cash for my vaporizer shop. I was going to hand it over to her because she wants to quit smoking anyway, right? So I figured it was a perfect fit. She's already in retail. She hates her job. She wants to get a new job, and she wants to quit smoking. So I built a vape shop, and you know, and everything. And then the kid starts threatening me. I guess he's jealous because I won't let him come over to the store and participate or whatever. So then he starts saying, "Oh, I'm gonna fight you. I'm gonna fight." I'm like, "All right, well, I made a video publicly to own it, you know, because I wasn't gonna, you know, sit and play these little email games or internet games." So I publicly was like, "All right, well, here we go then. Let's do it." And, you know, I quoted 1 Corinthians 13, you know, if your brother sins against you, what do you do? And all that. And anyway, so at the end, he sends his stepdaddy over. He won't fight me. You know, he's like, oh, I can't fight you until May. You know, this is January. I'm like, well, yeah, I'm in your town. You're in my town. We're together. We're 5 miles apart. Come on over. Let's do this. He's like, oh, I can't do it till May. You're going to have to wait till May. I'm like, well, I've already sold my fiveplex. You know, I'm done here. I got no business here anymore. I'm not going to stick around till May. So then he sends his stepdaddy over. Stepdaddy starts, you know, trying to fight me and wails on me a little bit. So I bloodied him up. He left. He calls the cops on me. And the cops come over and they're like, do you want to press charges? I'm like, nah, I just want a protective order. You know, I want a trespassing order so he doesn't come over here again. You know, I don't want my kids getting hurt. He's like, okay. So then I guess the guy calls him back because he's the one that called the cops on him. He calls him back. He's like, well, I want to, you know, press charges or whatever. I want something done with him because he's on the internet saying stuff. He's like, dude, he has a right to be on the internet. So anyway, after they call like 3 or 4 times, they come and charge me with disorderly conduct. I'm like, I was at my own house chilling. I was doing my own thing. They came over to me. So they charge us both. He was found guilty. My charges were dismissed. 3 or 4 months later, I get the cops called on me again several times. They tell me who it was. I have video of them telling me who it was. And it's the same kid. You know, he doesn't fight fair and whatever. So just like Hannity, and you'll see in this video, I started researching this. I'm like, okay, well, what the hell's going on? Looked up his criminal record on idcourts.us. And you can see it in this right here, in this post, this public complaint against Officer Tyler Evans. The kid had 2 charges of false accusations, 2 charges of phone harassment, all these other charges, restraining orders, protective orders from ex-girlfriends, all this. So I'm not the only one that gets it from this kid, but this is how the left play. This is how they roll. If they can't get their way, they'll try any way possible to silence you. That's just how it works. And so, you know, and I've talked a little bit about the informants here, and this kid's one of them, obviously, because he's willingly going to the police, sicking them on other people. And, you know, making false accusations. And that's the definition of an informant. Anyway, I want to get on to Sean Hannity here because we need to protect ourselves. Sean Hannity is doing an excellent job. He's given some good advice, and I think that it's relevant to what's going on today. And I don't think it's going to stop without taking action. So this is what I wanted to show you guys today. Take care. Check us out at CloVisStar.com. And if you'd like, subscribe to us and help us on Patreon, patreon.com/CloVisTribe.
I have to start tonight by addressing a well-orchestrated effort by the intolerant left in this country that is designed to silence every conservative voice and by any means necessary. Now, I am speaking out tonight so that you, our audience, will understand what is really happening here and what is really at stake when it comes to freedom of speech in this country. Now, these tactics are right out of Saul Alinsky's Rule for Radicals playbook. Now, I've worked in radio for 30 years. I've been right here at the Fox News Channel for 21 and a half years. I'm very proud of that. And during this time, there's always been efforts and attempts to smear and slander and besmirch me and other conservatives. But it has never been as intense and completely insane as it is right now. Now, I want you to understand, every single minute, every single second I am on the air, radio, TV, there's somebody likely being paid, recording and monitoring every single word that comes out of my mouth, all in the hopes that I may say something they can twist and distort and use against me and try and destroy my reputation, get my conservative voice off the air. Now, it's only gotten worse in the age of President Trump. Now, it's no secret I've been a supporter of the president and, of course, his policies. And quite simply, these liberal fascists, they can't stand conservative voices. Now, for those of you who don't know me well, I have a pretty thick skin. I call out people, I say things, I give my point of view 4 hours a day. And for all these years, well, there has been endless, unrelenting attacks against me. But now, in light of recent events, I have come to the conclusion I can no longer remain silent, and I can no longer let the left slander against me slide. So from now on, and I want you to be informed of what I'm doing and why I'm doing it, if there's any person, any group, any organization, any media outlet that slanders, lies about me, besmirches me, my character, I'm going to be calling them out. Because at this point, enough is enough. I have hired a team of some of the best attorneys in this country to work with me and on my behalf. Now, the breaking point for me came this weekend when an individual who for over a decade has made the most outrageous, unfair, untrue allegations against me has now resurfaced by making ridiculous and completely untrue claims. Now, this person went on a radio show on Friday and made more unfounded accusations against me, which this person is now, interestingly, recanting after I made my statement, but it was only after I responded to these baseless and false smears. This is not the first time I've had to deal with this individual. Now, this person has repeatedly spread lies about me. I'll give you an example. Back in 2010, remember I was raising money for the Freedom Alliance, a charity that offers college scholarships to the children of killed veterans, severely injured veterans, and their families. And in a blog post, the individual falsely accused me and members of the charity of skimming and stealing money that was donated. This, of course, was easily proven false. And in spite of the fact that we proved each and every single allegation to be untrue and inaccurate at the time, I was never given an apology. There was no correction that was issued. Now this person has made yet another slanderous accusation. And in response, I've released this statement, which now the press has picked up, and I'll read it for you. Let me be clear. The comments about me on a radio show this week by this individual are 100% false and a complete fabrication. This individual is a serial harasser who has been lying about me for well over a decade. The individual has a history of making provably false statements against me in an effort to slander, smear, besmirch my reputation. The individual has not just slandered me over the years, but also many people who this individual disagrees with. This individual desperately seeks attention by any means necessary, including making unfounded personal attacks and using indefensible and outrageous political rhetoric. My patience with this individual is over. I have retained a team of some of the finest and toughest lawyers in the country who are now in the process of laying out the legal course of action we will be taking against this individual. Now, in this fiercely divided and vindictive political climate, I will no longer allow slander and lies about me to go unchallenged, as I see this now to be a coordinated effort afoot to now silence those with conservative views. I will fight every single lie about me by any and all legal means available to me as an American. Now, I want you to know, my audience, to understand the importance of what is happening here. This is not about Sean Hannity. This is not about one person. There's now a coordinated attempt to silence the voice of every outspoken conservative in this country. If we don't stop it right now, there won't be any conservative voices on radio and television left. Now, I'm not the only one that these liberal fascists routinely target. Like me, conservatives are monitored on radio and TV every word they say. And contrary to the alt-radical left stated position, they're so open-minded liberals. Not true. Liberal fascism is alive and well in America today. Their goal is simple. They want to shut up, shut down, completely silence all conservative voices by any means necessary. Here's the difference. Unlike the left, I don't have any problem with what the other side says. If you want to listen to liberals on radio or TV, read their articles, follow them on social media, go for it. Now, I'll call them out for their bias, I'll explain why they're wrong, I'll debate them, but I'll never ever say they should be silenced. And I won't support boycotts to attack their advertisers a roundabout way of silencing them. So let me be clear tonight. Everyone who has publicly supported President Trump is a target. This is very political. We have seen repeatedly that the left knows no limits in these efforts. They have gone after and attacked the First Lady. They have attacked members of the president's family, every White House advisor. They've even attacked his daughter and his 10-year-old son. Now, ultimately, their goal is to cause as much collateral damage as they can to anybody that supports the president. They have tried to undermine the outcome of this election since November 9th. Please know, this isn't about me. This is about the left concocting boycotts, all in an attempt to silence prominent conservative voices. If we don't take a stand now, if we allow this to happen now, I am telling you, America as we know it, freedom of speech as we know it, is over. Let's stop the boycotts. Let's stop silencing opposition voices. Let all Americans make their own decisions. Joining us with Reaction, the author of the New York Times bestseller, Treason, former Speaker of the House, Fox News contributor.